Students, welcome to the online classes of your school. Today we will continue our chapter 9, that is algebraic expression and identities. So students, today we will do about identities. Here are four algebraic identities you have to study about. So first one is a plus b whole square. Whole square means this a plus b are included in this bracket and the whole square, okay, is equals to a square plus b square plus 2ab. And second is a minus b whole square equals to a square plus b square minus 2ab. In these two, students, you have to remember that if here is plus sign, so here will be plus 2ab. If minus sign is there, then minus 2ab will be there, okay. Now third is a plus b, a minus b, or we can say a minus b or a plus, a minus b and a plus b, okay, means bracket of plus then minus or the bracket of minus then plus, both thing are same or equal, we can say, and they are equals to a square minus b square. Now fourth one is x plus a and x plus b equals to x square plus in the bracket a plus b x plus a b. Students, you have to learn these four identities by heart, okay, because these will be helpful for solving the further questions. So first question is 2y plus 5 into 2y plus 5, okay. So here, as you know, that what we do that like 2 into 2 is equals to 2 square, means when the same values are repeating themselves in multiplication, they are two times, it means what we can write, we can write the square of this value, okay. So in this same manner, here is 2y plus 5, here is also 2y plus 5. So what we will do, we will write 2y plus 5 whole square. We can write as here 2 and 2 were two times and we write 2 square. Here 2y plus 5 and 2y plus 5 are 2 times, so we can write 2y plus 5 whole square, okay. Now what is the identity using here? Suppose 2y we are taking as a, suppose a here is 2y and b is 5 here, we are taking b as 5, okay. So here a is 2y and b is 5, it means what is the identity here? This is a plus this is b. So what is the identity? First identity is here a plus b whole square, and what is its value? A square plus b square plus 2ab, okay. So to solve this, what we will do, we will take this value. What is the value? We have to put a square. What is a? A is 2y in this, so 2y square. Plus sign is here, then b square. What is b? B is 5, so we will do the square of 5 here, okay. Then plus 2ab is here, 2ab means 2 into a into b. So what we will do, plus 2 into, what is a? A is 2y and what is b? B is 5, so we will substitute the values of a and b here, okay. So what we are getting, 2y square plus 5 square plus 2 into 2y into 5, okay. Now we will solve them. What is the value of 2y square? 2y is 4 and y is y square, so we get 4y square. Here 5 square is 25, so 25 is here. Now 2 is 4 and 4 5 is 20, and here is y, so our answer is plus 20y. So when we solve this, we are getting 4y square plus 25 plus, sorry, 4y square plus 25 plus 20y square, okay. Now next question is given to us, 3a minus 1 by 2 into 3a minus 1 by 2. So here, as we have done here, 2y plus 5 and 2y plus 5 were repeating itself in multiplication, so we have done it square. Here if we check, 3a minus 1 by 2 and 3a minus 1 by 2 are repeating themselves, so what we can do, we can write the whole square, 3a minus 1 by 2 whole square, okay. Now what is the identity here? If we consider 3a as a here and 1 by 2 as b here, so this is a minus b whole square. What will be its value? It will be equals to a square plus b square minus 2ab, okay. So what is a here? 3a, so 3a square. Then what is b? 1 by 2, so 1 by 2 square minus 2 into a is 3a and b is 1 by 2, okay. So we have substituted the values here. Students, when you are doing the multiplication part here, so you need not to put minus 1 by 2, okay, you will put 1 by 2 only, because in this minus, and in this case this plus sign is for the identity. You have to take only these terms, okay, without considering the sign. For the consideration of sign, what you have to do, you have to only put here. Okay, suppose if here is minus, you will put minus 2ab. If here is plus, we have put plus 2ab here. Okay, so a and b have their separate values despite of having any negative or positive value. Okay, so what we will do here, we are getting 3a square plus 1 by 2 square minus 2 into 3a into 1 by 2. So now we will solve it. Here 3a square, what we will get as an answer? 3 is 9, and a square will be a square, so 9a square. Now 1 by 2 square will be 1 is 1 and 2 is 4, so we get 1 by 4. And students, here if we cut this 2 by 2, because it is in denominator and it is numerator, and these 3 are in multiplication. So what are we left with? We are left with minus sign and 3a, so we get minus 3a. Okay, so we solve this question by the second identity, that is a minus b whole square is equals to a square plus b square minus 2ab, and we get the answer 9a square plus 1 by 4 minus 3a. Okay, now our next question is 6x minus 7, 6x plus 7. Okay, in this what we are getting? We are getting 6x here and here also. We are getting 7 and 7 also. It means here if we consider 6x as A and 7 as B. So what we are getting? We will put 6x as A, here is minus sign, then 7 as B. Same here, 6 as A, plus sign is here, then 7 as B. So what is this identity? This is third identity here. This is given to us, and it will be equals to a square minus b square. Okay, so here a minus b, a plus b is equals to a square minus b square. Okay, suppose students, if there is plus sign and there is minus sign, then also we have to use this same identity, and our answer will be a square minus b square only. Okay, so here we will put the values. We have to put a square minus b square, so in place of a, what is our value? A is 6x, so we will put 6x square, then minus sign, and b square is, b is 7, so it will be 7 square. Now 6x square is 36x square, because 6 into 6 gives 36, and x square is x square. So 36x square and minus, then 7 square is 49. So this we got as our answer by using third identity. Okay students, now our next question is 2a square plus 9 and 2a square plus 5. Here students, if you see, 2a square is in this expression and 2a square is also in this expression. Okay, but if we see the second term of both the expressions, both are different. Here it is 9 and here it is 5. It means if we say that we are taking 2a square as x, okay, and this 9 as a and 5 as b, because both have different values, so we will take different variables for them. Okay, so what will be the identity here? Here x and a, b are using, it means the fourth identity here. X plus a, x plus b is equals to x square plus a plus b, x plus a, b. Okay, here x is 2a square, as it is in both the brackets, it is first term of both the expression. Also here 2a square is in both the expressions. If we talk about the second term, then it is different in both, so we are naming as a and b. In this also 9 and 5, they are different. Okay, so what the identity we will use? We will use fourth identity, that is x a into x b is equals to x square plus a plus b in the bracket into x plus a b. Okay, so we will substitute the values in this expression, because this is given to us, means this is given to us, and we have to solve this. So what is x here? X is 2a square, so what we will put? We will put 2a square, and it is x square, so we will say that 2a square, the whole square, we have to solve. Then plus a plus b, what are a plus b? 9 and 5 are a plus b, so 9 plus 5. Then outside the bracket in the multiplication here is x. And what is x? X is 2a square again. So we will put 2a square. Then plus ab. Ab means a into b, means plus 9 is here, which is a, and 5. So 9 into 5. Okay. Now further solving this, 2 square will be 4 and a square will be a raised to the power 4. Okay, so its answer will be 4a raised to the power 4. Then 9 plus 5 will give us 14 and 2a square is in the multiplication. Now 9 5 is 45. Now 4a raised to the power 4 plus, now 14 2 is 28a square plus 45. Okay, so this is the answer for our this expression, 4a raised to the power 4 plus 28a square plus 45. In this, what we have done, we have simply check out what will be the identity used here. So fourth identity was using here, and according to that we will put the values in the answer. Now second question is 4x minus 5, and it is multiplied by 4x minus 1. Here if we check again, 4x and 4x are in both the expressions. It means we can consider as x and x. Now here this is 5 and this is 1. So these are different values. So we will consider them as a and b because these are different values. So again the fourth identity is here. X plus a into x plus b is equals to x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. Okay. Now here we have to put x square. So what is x here? 4x is the first one value which is common in both. So 4x square. Then plus here students, what we will do, as we know the identity about addition, so we have to take the sign accordingly. Here we will take a as minus 5. We will take a as minus 5 and b as minus 1. And as you know, here x is 4x. This term is 4x here. Okay. So here, while we are putting a plus b, so what we will write down? We write down the value of a as minus 5. And here as it is addition, so addition, then value of b is minus 1. So we will put it in the bracket, minus 1. And outside the bracket is x. And what is x here? X is this first term of both the expressions. So we will put 4x here. Then plus a into b. A into b means we have to multiply minus 5 to minus 1. Okay. Because these are the values of a and b according to this question. Now while solving 4x square, what we are getting? 4 is 16x square. So 16x square. Then when we open up this bracket, minus 1, so this plus minus will be minus, so minus 5 minus 1, 4x is as it is. When we will solve minus 5 and minus 1, what we will get? We will get 5, because minus minus gives us positive and 5 1 is 5. It is also positive, so positive 5. Now 16x square, here it was minus 5 minus 1 is minus 6, 4x plus 5. Now minus 6 into 4 gives us minus 24, and x is here in the multiplication. So by solving this middle term, we are getting 6 4 is 24 and plus minus is minus, minus 24x. So our answer is 16x square minus 24x plus 5 for our this question. Now next question is 2.5p minus 1.5q whole square minus 1.5p minus 2.5q and then whole square. Okay, in this we have to simplify it. So students, if we check this part, what identity we will use? We will use a minus b whole square, the second one identity. So a minus b whole square will be a square plus b square minus 2ab. Okay, here it is minus sign, so we will put minus sign. Now how we will solve this second expression? Here it is also a minus b and the whole square, so we will put again the second identity, which is a square plus b square minus 2ab. Here 2 into a is this and b is 2.5q. okay, now we will start solving them. Here 2.5p whole square will give us 2.5 square will be 6.25 and p square is p square. Here 1.25 will be 2.25 and q square. Here when we solve this part, here you can easily do like this. 2.5 into 2 gives us 5, and 5 multiplied 1.5 will give us 7.5. And as here P and Q are in the multiplication, so we will write PQ. And here is the minus sign, okay? As it was A square plus B square minus 2AB. So minus 2AB is this. Now again minus sign is here. Here we will put that in the bracket. Why? Because here is the minus sign in front of the bracket. So when we took out the values after the bracket, so because of minus sign, their values, their sign will be changed. Okay, so first of all, within the bracket we will solve their values. So 1.5 p square will give us 2.25 p square. Now plus 2.5 q whole square will give us 6.25 q square. Here minus 2 ab, so 2 into 1.5 p into 2.5 q will give us minus 7.pq. Okay, in the next step, what we have to do, we will simply write these three terms as it is. Now when we will open up this bracket, so due to minus sign, their sign will be changed. Here 2.25 p square is positive, so it will become negative. Here plus 6.25 q square is positive, so it will be negative. Here minus minus will be positive, so plus 7.5 pq. Okay students, now what we will do, we will try to add and subtract the like terms. So first of all, we will combine them. Here 2.6.25 p square is given. Here p square term is this, minus 2.25 p square. So we will write them together. Then we will take q square terms. So here it is plus 2.25 q square. Here it is minus 6.25 q square. So we will write these two terms together, okay, q square terms, as they are like terms. Now if you will check, it is minus 7.5 pq, it is plus 7.5 pq. These are like terms, as in both the terms it is pq and pq, and here it is plus 7.5, it is minus 7.5. so while solving them, they will give us the answer 0, so we can cancel them out. Okay, so what is left? We are left with these four terms. Okay, so by solving this, 6.25 p square minus 2.25 p square will give us 4 p square. Okay, and plus 2.25 q square minus 6.25 q square will give us minus 4 q square. Okay, as here 6.25 is greater and it is of negative sign, so negative 4 q square is here. So the answer is 4 p square minus 4 q square for this question.